De regreso aquí en Auto 060 para el último segmento del show de esta semana, la edición especial en la cobertura del Gran Premio de Fórmula 1 de Estados Unidos con Shell y Escudería Ferrari. Hemos dejado lo mejor para el final. Esta es una serie de preguntas que hicimos en un formato de grupo ahí con Fernando Alonso, el piloto de la Ferrari, después de que manejó los autos del Shell Eco Marathon. Y bueno, la primera pregunta aquí en español es sobre su opinión de la importancia de este proyecto que Shell patrocina desde hace ya mucho tiempo en Europa y desde el 2007 acá en Estados Unidos, que por cierto, en el 2015 cambia de sede después de haberse celebrado en Houston, Texas, la sede de Estados Unidos de la Shell. Ahora va a pasar a Detroit, donde obviamente por ser la capital del auto en Estados Unidos va a cobrar una nueva importancia. Y bueno, le hemos preguntado aquí a Fernando Alonso qué opina de lo que significa el desarrollo de estos autos del Shell Eco Marathon, que desarrollan hasta 480 millas por galón de combustible.
Bueno, es un trabajo fenomenal, ¿no? Un trabajo de mucha inteligencia, de mucha pasión, porque aparte de ser estudiante en la universidad, tienes que tener pasión por el deporte, por el motor, y cuando crean coches de este tipo, tan eficientes y tan sofisticados, pues siempre yo creo un orgullo y una manera de motivar a la gente nueva también que llega a la universidad para conseguir estos retos.
Bueno, y ahora aquí pasamos ya a las preguntas en inglés que hicieron nuestros colegas ahí durante la actividad que tuvimos con Fernando Alonso y la Shell durante el Gran Premio de Fórmula 1 de Estados Unidos allá en Austin, Texas.
Along the lines of the efficiency questions that we have, what are your thoughts on the fuel conservation measures this year? Is it something that's popular among the drivers, or what are your thoughts on that?
Obviously it adds something more, something new to the strategy and to the driving style. So it was not a big change, but it was a change on our side as well. And when there is something new, we all like it, because there is something new to experiment and to improve. So I think it was a good experience so far. Obviously the technicians and the strategies, they are progressing so much from the race one to now. And every race we have to save less and less fuel, because they know how to make the car more and more efficient. So it's making it easier the life of the drivers now in the last time.
Well, I think it can be as they are, and in the direction to be more and more efficient. I think we have now hybrid engines in Formula One. Last year we were using around 140 kilograms to the race. This year is 100, so it's a big change, and it was possible. So I think even if we reduce another 50%, let's say, a big change, the technology and the engineering ideas will be always on top of any rule change, and that will be the best thing for the future, you know, to move closer to a road car or to a more eco environment.
And after talking about the new efficiency rules in Formula One, Fernando Alonso started talking about the new, the future of the new team and the Formula One for the United States, the Gene Haas team that will debut in 2016. So the question was if he knew anything about it, about the project, what's going on, and what are the plans?
Because they were on the Ferrari garage and they were discussing some of the things they will do, but I don't know anything about the project or how they plan to go in, but it's very good news, you know, especially this race. We have two teams less, Caterham and Marussia, so there are some problems on the sport that I hope we can find a solution, because it's not normal, you know, that every year there are two or three teams that are on the economical problems. So if new teams are coming, we just need to find a way to help them to have a sport that is attractive for everybody.
How long do you think it'll take them to be successful?
It depends. The investment depends of how they approach the project. We saw
projects like Red Bull that they've been dominating for the last 4 or 5 years. That they arrived in 2004, I guess. They bought Jaguar at that time, and then they took 6 or 7 years to win the championship. And it required a lot of investment and a lot of desire to win. There are other new teams that arrived recently that they were just 3 or 4 seconds off the pace, and they were at the back of the grid. I think for Haas will depend on how they approach the project, how the commitment will be on the Formula One in a long term. And unfortunately, in this sport, the money you spend is the results of work.
One more quick one. Would you consider driving for the Haas F1 team in 2016?
No.
The next question for Fernando Alonso was about what it will take for the Gene Haas Formula One team to be successful when they start competing in 2016.
I think first of two important things to be successful in America Formula One will be a driver that is competing at the top level for podiums, for points and for victories, and a team which is important, but I will put first priority a driver to become really strong in America. So you have a team coming, so that's the first step. Hopefully we see a driver this week.
Have you talked to Gene?
No, only met him, more than 10 seconds.
You said that you hardly ever watch NASCAR. How much do you know of it? I mean, do you know the drivers or
I only, to be honest, I play on video games, the PlayStation, and I choose Jeff Gordon, and I choose other cast because I like the colors, I like the sponsors, but on TV, sometimes I pass the channels and I see the NASCAR, but not really into sport, not really understanding the strategies or anything, so I don't watch much.
Your teammate says he wants to race NASCAR again at some point. Do you ever have any desire to do that as a race
car? Honestly not. I never had on my mind that, but who knows? You can never close the door to anything, it doesn't come to my mind now. I never tried, I never watched it. It will be very difficult for me to adapt to something very new. But maybe 5 or 6 years time, you feel some attraction from the sport, and who knows? It's something that at the moment I don't see, but who knows?
Interesantes los conceptos de Fernando Alonso, el piloto de la Ferrari, sobre la NASCAR, sobre el equipo de Gene Haas para la Fórmula 1 en el 2016, sobre las nuevas reglas de eficiencia que están haciendo la competencia, quizá un poco más pareja. Vamos a ver qué pasa el año próximo, cuando seguramente habrá nuevos ajustes a todo esto. Y sobre todo vamos a ver si, como dijo ahí al final, dentro de 5 o 6 años, Fernando Alonso sigue los pasos de Juan Pablo Montoya, que estuvo, por cierto, ahí en la carrera también y debuta en la serie NASCAR de aquí en Estados Unidos. Gracias a Pam Rosen del grupo de relaciones públicas de Shell por la invitación al Gran Premio de Fórmula 1 en Austin. Y como siempre, les recomiendo que vayan al canal de YouTube para que vean todas las actividades que estuvimos cubriendo por allá. Yo soy Javier Mota y los espero muy pronto en otra edición de Auto 060.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.